Yeah, well, Lauren, it's unnerving to some people I talk to who say that they're now either having to walk with one headphone in or looking over their shoulder when they typically don't have to. But there are ways to avoid confrontation in the first place, and we heard some examples of that as police continue to investigate.
It's a little concerning. I hope, it doesn't escalate into something bigger.
Samantha Maureen is watching her back after Durham police warned of a sexual assault suspect that's been touching people inappropriately in the residential area of Copperleaf Parkway since March.
I have not walked alone since, and I definitely won't put both headphones in going forward, but we're kind of sticking together and keeping our eye out for him for sure.
Durham police patrolling the area on Tuesday, just days after Raleigh police investigated a separate incident involving assault on the Greenway near Lake Wheeler Road.
You have to look at where you are.
Scott Johnson, who teaches self-defense in Wake County, divides the lesson into two parts, starting with awareness.
If you're in a place that's isolated, then you're going to be more vulnerable. If you're in a place where, there's shops that you can walk into, then do that.
And delaying physical confrontation, whatever that may involve.
You're creating space with the person. Again, you're making noise. But whatever you can to delay whatever is happening, you're creating opportunities for you to get out of the situation.
For Maureen, she feels safer in a group.
We still walk in the middle of the day, and I'm with my husband, so I hope he'll protect me. But we walk in groups. I mean, it's not stopping us from anything, but it's definitely keeping us on guard.
And so again, in both cases involving assault and sexual assault in Raleigh and Durham, police are still investigating. Reporting in Durham, Cindy Bain, ABC 11 Eyewitness News.